So we're going to go check out this house that we saw on the way. We went to go check out a staircase in the forest and that didn't work. So now we're checking out a little yellow house. That looks like it's turned into quite the party zone. It's not sketchy, but it's sketchy because there's no more dangerous. Yeah, it's more dangerous than sketchy of a location. Let's go in this way. It's all collapsed. People still can't see. There we go. Now you can see inside this house. It doesn't feel safe. But, oh, that's spongy. A lot of mold in here too. Yeah, Tim, I'd be careful walking on some of these floors. This person was definitely a hoarder. Literally walking on garbage. Quite literally. Oh, here's the kitchen. Hey, there's a jar of pickles up here. Pickles! Alright. I don't know if there's a floor under here. Oh, this is sketchy. Alright. Well, there's a stove. A little dishwasher or something going on there. Refrigerator. There's even a little mirror over there. Well, this is pretty cool. You're standing very, very, very close for this place to not have floors. Look all inside of here. Yeah, I heard a squeak.
You heard a squeak too?
Yeah.
That's my LED.
I'm gonna try the upstairs. It's kind of risky. It looks like it's not very safe. Most of this is floating. There's a fucking wig. No, I'm done. This is super sketchy. And it's not sketchy because of the location. It's sketchy because there's like little to no floor. Little to no floor, like I said. A cool little dresser. Kinda hard to see in here because, well, my camera doesn't work too well. Holes in the roof, slate's falling off. Some old Christmas lights. This person was definitely a hoarder. I can definitely tell you that. And I think there definitely was a fire at one point. A lot of these walls are black. I don't think that's mold. I'll film you going up for insurance purposes. Yeah, and there's no floor. I'm gonna go check out that blue book you were talking about. Be careful up there, dude. That floor is not safe. I wouldn't walk around anywhere up there. Oh yeah, no, this is totally a hoarder. I mean, there's even like a little diabetic kit going on here. A one-touch meter. There's still food in the refrigerator. That's weird. They just up and left food. Oh, here's a calendar. October 2010, it says. These are some of the stranger explorers that I did. It's strange because you don't really know the history of it. It's just kind of, everybody just kind of gets up and leaves. They don't say anything. And, I mean, there's literally a mattress coming through the floor. And there's like scarves and stuff just kind of hanging there. You guys can't even see that, but it's weird. Yeah, a lot of these places are just kind of, like, the houses are very strange because usually there's no history to it. They either go bankrupt, foreclose, and then they just kind of left it erupt. And then people like me come out here and explore these places. Right, Tim?
Right.
Why is everybody's name Tim? I don't understand that. I'm Tim, you're Tim. He's Jim and you're Jim.
It's just the name my mom gave me.
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah, my birthday.
How was it up there?
I like all these books that are like, it's like a waste. You like, it's gonna go put in like a library or something. Look at this dude, he's chilling in a wheelchair looking all tough.
Yeah, I'd come up there with you, but I don't really trust this building. I don't know. Is there a person in here? There's a lot of wigs, dude. There's a pink one down here. It's just a wig, guys. Alright. Well, that's good. Yo, what are you doing? What?
He was a cross-dresser?
You found a letter? Hold on. I need to get up there. I need to... Found... So we're in a cross-dresser's house. Okay.
That explains the wigs.
Yeah, because there's a lot of wigs. Oh.
So I just found this, letter that is addressed to Trick Connor.
Hold on.
I don't know if that means anything to anybody. I don't see a date on it. Dear Pamela, I appreciate your recent letter. I'm happy that you have taken such an interest in what has transpired on television regarding cross-dressing. We do have a long way to go before the public and media people recognize that we are not gay, that we are harmless, and we all have a long way to go before we find out the real reasons for cross-dressing. I was on a program in Portland recently, and a doctor agreed with what I had said in that he believed that the reason for most of the cross-dressing is biological and not psychological. This attitude by the medical people is good, since most medical people in the past have categorized us as psychological misfits. It's time for a change. I will keep in mind your suggestions pertaining to television shows featuring cross-dressing. It is a problem, although our best reply is to get on television or in the newspaper. I also agree that we do have to keep a distance from the gay community, since it could be very harmful to us if we were to become lumped into that group. I have gay friends, but just the same, I do not want to get too close to the gay associations, since being labeled gay could be very harmful in many ways. Sharon is here today, helping me get the Trias buying guide into the mail. The supplement to the directory is at the printers. Otherwise, it's back to answering letters. I do appreciate your writing. Sincerely, Carol. I'm assuming
so that the camera
must be his
cross-dresser
name.
Yeah. Look at that, his little go-kart.
A piano. A little piano right there.